listening to Freefloating Radio, a new radio program about free-floating musical projects. Today is science and ancient mysteries. The show is presented to you by freefloating.com. Your host for today's show is Steve. Welcome to this first edition on this free-floating radio. And today we start with a fresh CD from Sven Hansen with the song Mars X. Chronicle made music. It's all synthesizer. This song is from his new album, The Earth-Mars Connection. And apparently the Earth-Mars Connection is what free floating is all about. Science from today and ancient mysteries. Later in the show to have a chat with Sven on the internet or on the telephone, and we will see what he has to tell about his album. Okay, well, this radio show is just beginning, and we had some problems with some technical problems on the internet, but we're going to make this program anyhow. Alright. Well, another song from the CD, The Earth-Mars Connection, is now about to come for you. cosmic electronic music. Very nice, done by Sven Hansen. And on his CD, he tells a little bit about the background of his music. I can tell something you can read here. Sven Hansen is a modern day explorer who explores the mysteries of today. Well, we have sent some questions to Sven Hansen on the internet, and we are opening our mail to see if he had some answers for us. And one of the questions we were asking Sven was, what is the exact connection between Earth and Mars? And I read here his response, and he said, well, in the ancient history of our solar system, Mars had a period of a dense atmosphere and was probably similar like Earth today. That alone is a connection. But there is also ancient artifacts, anomalies called by modern science, which by closer study are remains of an ancient city. Wow, that is really mysterious. Mysterious stuff here. Before we go further, and we have some new music from Sven Hansen from his album The Mystery. This is a slow version from the version that's on the album. We have Sven Hansen at the telephone at this moment to welcome Sven Hansen.
Hello.
You are right now in the show.
Okay.
Tell us something about this album of yours. When did you start to create the album?
Well, I started the album Earth-Mars Connection in 2005. When I just had finished the Atlantis album, and I went browsing around on the internet just to get some inspiration on what to do next. And what came up were pictures from Mars taken by the Mars Global Surveyor. And those pictures were beautiful pictures taken from ravines, ancient oceans, and many other things. But also, there were some strange pictures some pictures from Mars Global Surveyor. And one picture grabbed my attention. That was a picture called AB104205, and that picture had some anomalies on it in the lower right corner, and there was also a website which explained those anomalies, and they explained it, and they made some kind of drawing with many lines on it, and they explained it as a city.
Wow, that's amazing. Yes. A city on Mars.
Yes, it is. And then I wanted to know more about it, and I started my own investigation about this picture. And what came clear to me was that there were some sand dunes. The sand from Mars was blown by the wind, and there came to some obstacles, which were houses and temples or other kind of features. When I zoomed in on those features, I clearly see some features which were connected to some ancient Maya temples and ancient Maya sites in Copan or Yucatan or Chichen Itza. And it became clear to me that those ancient sites had some connection with sites which were seen on the picture AB104205. So, and that was my big inspirational moment for the Earth-Mars connection.
Okay, Sven, so your inspiration came from a picture taken from a NASA website which had your attention, and from that picture which detailed a city, and you created a whole album with beautiful music, I must say. But I don't think that many listeners who are listening this podcast or radio broadcast at this moment believe that there is a city or ancient city on the planet Mars, because nothing has been said in the news or in the media or whatsoever. What is your comment on that?
Well, I think that modern-day media doesn't mention any of this because they are very reluctant to mention any new discoveries regarding ancient history or ancient technologies found by modern day scientists.
Okay, Sven, so you think that the media from today is a little bit ashamed of mentioning discoveries regarding ancient civilizations on other planets in our solar system?
Well, I don't know if they are ashamed about it, but I do know that that the media does not mention these discoveries to the general public. The reason about this, I can only guess. I don't know what the reason is that they don't mention it.
Well, that reason will still be a mystery to us, and maybe that is why your music is such mysterious in nature. And we like to listen to another song from your new album, The Earth-Mars Connection.
Houston, do you copy? Houston, do you copy? We see houses of some kind. There was some kind of human life here. Houston, do you copy? Houston, do you see this? There is a complete city over here. Do you copy? This looks like the Maya city. Houston, do you copy? It looks like an ancient Maya city. The buildings are partially covered with sand. We see things and features we don't understand. Houston, copy. Does anyone know about past life on this red planet? Does anyone know about spacecraft in ancient time? Copy, Houston. This is officially off the record. It has desolate, yet living woods. It scares the hell out of me. I wish I was never on this craft. First manned mission to Mars. How does this relate to our existence on Earth? Are we really alone?
Houston copy from Sven Hansen's New City Earth-Mars Connection. And we have Sven Hansen on the telephone line. Sven, you have used some kind of voice in this song, Houston Copy. How did you create that that voice? Did you hire someone to speak those words, or how did you do that?
Well, I didn't hire someone to speak those words. But I used a computer speech program, and with that speech program, which is in, by the way, in every average used computer in the world, I made those sentences in the song Houston Copy.
Okay, that's very interesting to know that you used a voice computer program to create this song. I think that's never been done before.
Well, I don't know if it is done before, but to me it's a kind of experimental way of using computer voice technique into music and to make some kind of musical sound and expression with it.
Okay. Also in the song we hear the word Stendek repeated. Where does that word come from, and what does that mean? What is the inspiration for the word Stendek?
Well, the word Stendek actually came from a book I read about the Bermuda Triangle, and there was a story in that book about five Avenger torpedo bombers who disappeared above the triangle. And in the radio transmissions, there was the word Stendek repeated three times. And that story was also an inspiration to put right in this song called Houston Copy.
So your music is inspired by written stories in books and what you have heard or read on the internet, which are actually documentaries of real-life happenings.
Well, that's correct. My inspiration comes from everyday experience, including all the experiences of people or stories who were written in books about real-life happenings. And I think the story about Mars, or the city on Mars, is one of the real-life happenings in this time. But the media of this time don't want us to know. Or the people who control the media doesn't want to get this information out. So this is one aspect why I put this information on my musical CD.
All right, and have you sold many copies of your CD at this moment?
Well, the number of copies I don't actually know. You have to ask my record company about that.
Okay, we will do that. But in the meantime, we will listen to your new musical CD, The Earth-Mars Connection, on podcast and internet radio. A lot of electronics here in this new music of Sven Hansen, Earth-Mars Connection. We have at this moment Sven Hansen on the telephone line live here in this show with us. Sven, we have to ask you some questions about this music, where the fans of your music worldwide are very anxious to hear about. What are the influences in this song called Ancient Air Combat?
Well, Ancient Air Combat is influenced by Jeff Wayne from the 1978 LP musical version of War of the Worlds, and also by some ancient sagas from ancient wars in the sky.
So your music is inspired by those ancient sagas. In fact, you are not the first person who takes sagas as an inspirational source. I know that Björk also has an inspiration of old sagas to make music. And what can you tell us more about these sagas and ancient stories?
Well, these stories inspired me in such a way that I began to think about it, and I thought, how could I translate those stories into music? What kind of sounds would fit those kind of mysterious stories? Those stories which are never really understood by the people.
And this album of yours is all about connections, and I see that you not only made connections between ancient artifacts and music, but also between ancient artifacts found on Earth and ancient artifacts found on Mars. Specific, you also have on your artwork some kind of mask and some kind of face with a large forehead on it. What can you tell us about that mask and those pictures?
Well, in Peru there were skulls exhibited in a museum, and those skulls had a very large forehead, and those skulls were never shown up in the evolution of man. Those skulls with very large foreheads fit exactly some archaeological finds of an ancient mask found in modern day Iraq, which were perfectly connected with the skulls that were explained in the museum in Peru.
So there is not only a connection between all those things, but also in ancient times. You say by this music you make a statement that in the very ancient times there were a connection between Peru and Iraq.
Well, there is still a lot of mystery in our evolvement in the ancient times of humankind. And still today science has no answer to how to explain the biological features of the skulls found in Peru. So that leaves a lot of speculation about the evolution of mankind in our ancient history.
So this album is not only a musical statement, but is also a statement for science today, I believe, and that maybe our evolution might be very different than we've been taught.
Yes, I think that our evolution is different because there are still missing links and not recognized by science. And those the skulls with the large foreheads, that can be one of the missing links in our evolution. And I think that in our ancient past, those people with the large foreheads were warriors, and they came down from the sky and conquered Earth. Maybe they came from Mars, but they conquered Earth and they left many strange artifacts or strange things on Earth. still not explained today by modern science.
So this CD, what this CD is all about is more than meets the eye. We have a fantastic first half hour of our show, and we would like to thank you, Sven, for this first half hour.
You're welcome.
In our show, and thank you for this interview. We have your number and we will call you back if we have more questions, and we hope to see you in the next half hour of our show. And first we